Hello, welcome to episode 17 of this first look and playthrough of Stellaris, Paradox Games' space game, 4X. Expand, explore, exploit, exterminate, or something like that. And I'm wondering what to do because I'm surrounded by fairly powerful empires. Are these really? Nope. Overwhelmingly powerful. Inferior. But they're a vassal under the chimes. And these are superior and hostile. I think I should end my rivalry with them because they're too close. I should be rivals with someone who's further away. I'm already rivals of them, okay. Erudite explorers. Collectivist, xenophile, materialist. How much will I get for it? Plus 0.07 influence per month. Not worth it. Okay. Now these are superior. They're a fair distance away. Individualist. But xenophile. Plus 0.2, is it worth it? Really? Oh, we're now friends at plus 100. Okay, well, don't want to waste that. Plus 0.04. Waste of time. And these are pals. Very difficult. The Chim are doing way too well though, I have to say. Can I get my ships back, by the way? Chim are actually like one of the most powerful, and they're right next to me. I'm not so weedy in terms of space, though. If there were some planets up here, I could do something. I get a load of planets, basically. That's it. I guess I'll have to go to war with these guys again and try. These are unoccupied. Will it annoy the Chim if I do that, though? A space, presumably, so I can't do it. Yes, they're a Chim protectorate. Hey, are those the only two worlds these guys have left? Federation with the Rutharian Assembly of Suns and Sovereign Onotark Suns. Member of the Alliance. Member of the Alliance. So if I declare war on them, I get these alliances after me, presumably. Frontier outpost. Not getting much for this one. I might do better to oh no, it's a wormhole station only. Okay.
Construction complete.
Got out of that place. Let's see what I can see. That's their flag. The diplomatic relation to the selected empire. Opinion. AI attitude. So the selected empire is mine, presumably. So I take it that these guys don't like me. Seems reasonable.
Alphatucana this and that.
And neither do these much anyway. Opinion empire borders coloured based on their opinion of the selected empire. Isn't this the same? But that's AI attitude, that's opinion. Right. Diplomatic relation. So these have no particular diplomatic relation, right? Seven influence per month, not worth a minus 100.
Incoming transmission.
Joining together against possible threats. What's the deal? Is this like a non-aggression pact? No, I think it isn't. Right. Well, I'm exploring the diplomatic possibilities, but it's not looking good. Basically. Quite friendly attitudes from all these, and quite hostile from these. Since I have a defensive pact with the Chim, it would be good to provoke these into attacking me, wouldn't it? They transfer a system to me. Well, forget all that. Obviously, it's not going to happen. Right. This is in Chim space, but these are not. Would it be audacious to steal those planets? Probably. Rivals with the Uruxo. In several federations. Migration treaty with them. Maybe I should just focus on building up my fleet for some inevitable war, which is going to happen at some point. This is the only planet anywhere that I could do anything with. In Confederated Systems, how do you do? Federation Builders, there's enough of them. Individualist. Pacifist. My science ship, has it got back yet? Find the planet, and I've lost the ship. Right, there we go. Now, where's my science craft? Oh, there's one in Nedum already. Don't want a science craft there, I want this one here. And there's this, here we go. What's going on? Oh, somebody's died. Come here, and around this moon, build a mining station. Thank you. Oh, who's my best scientist? He's on engineering. He's in a spaceship. I'll go for him. Yep. Now I need to recruit another scientist. Research speed, field manipulation, spark of genius. Ooh. Custom AI assistant. Spark of genius sounds good to me. So now I have a science ship without a leader. Get him up some levels, hopefully. Although, he's got nothing to do. In fact, where's the ship? There, okay. Head home and help with the research, I would say. Are there more sorts of corvettes? Should I design another type of destroyer, like a torpedo destroyer? Maybe I should.
Research complete.
Excellent. Cheaper ships. Biolab 2. Ooh. Tire blockers. Ship repair beef. Ship upkeep down if I do that.
Construction complete.
How difficult. We do need to get rid of some of these tire blockers though. Designs. Destroyer. Are there other types of destroyer there? Antimatter blue laser destroyer. Can this be upgraded in some way? There's already. So let's make a new one. Some large weapon slot. Point defense, which is always helpful. What will be the large weapon? I'll have to try it and see. These things don't take torpedoes, but they.
Construction complete.
Thank you. Hey. A lot of damage there, and some point defense. Okay. Okay, now plus 30 power, what's the advantage of that? All fusion reactors. It's cheaper, yes. I'm still plus 10 there, and it's cheaper, right? That's 319 cost. Or... $339. Evasion 33.8. Armor slightly better. Well, I suppose these are pennies I'm talking about, really. Do it, okay. Advanced shields, some of that, some of that. Well, I don't know. But those are quite powerful in terms of their destruction. Accuracy 100%, I like that. So if I look at the other destroyer, it has two of those anyway. Small though, damage 10 to 11 to 15. Build a selection of them and hope for the best, really, isn't it? That's the plan. Good. This is all sort of maintenance stuff because I have no big plan here. Run out of money. I'm kind of locked in now, unless I go to war with these, ultimately. What do these guys think of me? They're neutral. But super powerful. they're the ancients, a fallen empire of the past. Ooh.
Research complete.
Quantum missiles. Battleship, but expensive. Belfarian power plant, whatever it is, could be useful because it's. I've got some of that that material on one of my planets somewhere. Hello, hello. Something not exploited. These robots are not breeding. What's going on? How do I manufacture more robots?
Construction complete.
Adapt new methods. Okay. Engineering, physics, and society output. Ooh. Food plus 10%, hydroponics farm bill cost minus 20%. Yeah, but I mean, these are robots, right? I've no idea if any of these are any good. Quite clear it now. I can. Mm-hmm. Right. Okay. Maybe I'm supposed to just dump more robots here with more colony ships.
Research complete.
350 minerals needed for that. Okay, what's this? Better combat stuff. Should upgrade my ships all over again now. I've done half of this research already. Let's get on with it.
Construction complete. Research complete.
Uh-huh. Galactic Stock Exchange. Produces one energy. Maintenance is 3. Huh? Maintenance is 3 energy, it produces 1. Oh, energy credits plus 10%. That could be useful, I suppose. The Xeno Zoo. Let's go to the stock exchange first. It looks interesting. Is anything happening, Mr. Governor? Governor Slurfudge.
Incoming transmission.
No, I don't want a defensive alliance or on a non-aggression pact only. Okay, he's ruling it. Good. Am I able to clear these, or I can't do anything, can I? No. Okay. He'll sort them out when he feels like it. So what happens here? Again, the robots are just not breeding, so I don't know what... I should look that up briefly. Let me just pause this for a second. Alright, looks like I have to build them to be up to the governor of the sector, so I should check that he's able to build robots. Strike craft damage plus 10%. I don't know which is a strike craft. Fighter pilots, Good, but I don't have any strike craft, do I? I think I'll probably get some sometime. Vassalized stuff going on. So let me look at the sector governor. He can build robots if he wants to. Okay. Fine. The Alioth sector could do with some more planets in it, really, couldn't it?
Construction complete.
My fleet is now... what? 2.5k power. Still nothing compared with some of those other guys. Oh, upgraded to quantum missiles. Ho 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 ho. Very nice. Okay. So they are updating automatically as they're supposed to. Excellent. That's the auto cruiser, it likes mass drivers. To 34, 12 to 17. Oh, it's medium. Maybe I can only do small quantum missiles at the moment. Can't build battleships yet, right? My fleet as well, shouldn't I? If they need it. How do I do that? Send them to the station for upgrade, yes? Didn't see a button for it, I thought there was one. See if I can send you back in order to upgrade or something. I thought there was an option to do that. Maybe it's just to repair. Basically, nothing. Right. No upgrade available. Oh, okay. Well, I'm going to have a battleship one day, aren't I? Um, Well, nothing's happening in the game basically at the moment. I could put a thingy, one of these outposts here, and then add it to that sector. And that would... that would cut the cost of the frontier outpost, whilst giving me 11 minerals. Just trying to find ways to make it more efficient, that's all.
Construction complete.
Belong to me, yeah, indeed. Making losses of energy. Why? Station maintenance, ship maintenance. Building maintenance, army maintenance, module maintenance. So obviously I need to gain about 10 soon, just to break even in the long run. In the medium term, really, I suppose it is. Better look at that next. I saw something here while I'm waiting. Expansion planner. But these are in other people's territory, right? Isn't it? No, it's on the far side of the galaxy, though. I'm sure that would annoy them immensely, but... I can go round these friendly guys. Well, neutral and friendly. A new sector over there, perhaps? I'll try it, shall I? Just as soon as this is done. Let's start, actually. building a colony ship. And I will need to get a constructor heading that way. But wait a minute, let me consider other places where I can expand my empire first, after all.
Construction complete.
Bingo, we're back. And now, sectors. There we go. And I think when the month is out or something, I will regain that point from the outpost. No. I thought you got your points back when you put them in a sector. This over there, this one over there, this one over there, this one up there. There's a whole bunch of them over there. Well, three of them anyway. Big, big, big. How will I get over there? These are my rivals. Those are my rivals, aren't they? No, they're not rivals anymore, these. What's the politics like with them? Not very good by the looks of it. We're not even rivals.
Construction complete.
Oh, a collectivist xenophobe, well, it stands to reason. Well, I have to expand somehow. I do have my defensive alliance with the Chim, who are pretty powerful. Thank you. see if I can even get there. I don't know. Frontier outpost minus four. But I thought when you put them in a sector, they didn't count against you. I have one, two, three, four. It's counting them still. It's a shame. Send science ship, don't I? I need to survey the systems. But it's given me all the info on them, so they must have been surveyed by somebody.
Incoming transmission.
Agree. A bit strange building an empire all the way over here with effectively no support. Okay, good. I thought I'd already agreed to that. Oh, I have, yeah. Okay. I want these worlds. 100%, 100%, 85%, 85%.
Incoming transmission.
Defensive pact. No. Non-aggression pact is fine.
Gana, this was not.
Hmm. through there. Some lavas all around. Who are these guys then? Oh! The Iroxo again. Can I get my worlds back? I doubt it. Could I get one of them back? See, to liberate a planet, I would need a huge war score.
Construction complete.
That's pointless. Okay. Construction complete. Okay. All three of you. Oh. I can at least get this far, so let's do that. Question is, how do I get around and through here? Who are these guys? Ah, okay, that's quite good. I can squeeze through the gap here, hopefully. That might be too far away. And these guys, who are they? Is there nobody here? They're not claimed. And these are not pals. It began as a subtle shift in Hythian behaviour. Scattered reports of their ships, once rarely seen outside their own space, now being spotted in remote systems all across the galaxy. Highly advanced scouting vessels visiting ancient ruined worlds, refusing all hails and fleeing when attacked. Their purpose and mission unknown. Until now. We now know that the Hythian were preparing, recovering the databanks of survey beacons and automated scouting posts left behind when they retreated to their present borders, gathering information for their return to the galactic stage. In Hythian space, fleets are gathering, armies are being mustered, and ancient factories rear to life. For the first time in an age, the Hythian crusaders are looking outwards beyond their borders and towards the galaxy at large. As their decaying shipyards are repaired and refitted, and the dormant systems of Titan foundries come online, the rest of the galaxy is left with only one question. Who will this once sleeping giant target first in their quest to reclaim age-old glory lost? Child of the stars, hear us. We are the Hythian Crusaders, the chosen people of this galaxy. Fanatic spiritualist, yep. For centuries, we have neglected our duties towards the spiritual needs of the lesser species, but no more. Accept our doctrines and convert, or be ground to dust, attempting futile resistance. There is no other choice. So some sort of strange symbiote they look like, don't they? Let's hope they attack these guys first. But if I settle there, they'll probably attack me first, won't they? That's an hour. We shall see how it goes. See you in part... whatever the next is, 17 or something. Or is it 18? I don't know. Bye for now.